Hey hotties, it's your girl Leslie, and if you see the rack behind me, you know it's time for another styling session. If you've been wondering how to incorporate this season's trends into your wardrobe, stay tuned. This video is just for you. Today we're going to be talking all about how to incorporate fall trends into your existing wardrobe. If you haven't already, be sure to click subscribe so that you never miss any of my weekly uploads. On this channel, we talk about everything from style and fashion to luxury travel, food, motherhood, and everything in between, with the hope that I can show you that you too can live a magnificent life, or what I like to call the hot life. So let's dive right in. Behind me, I have a rack full of items that I've already owned with a few pieces inserted in to ensure that I'm on trend for the season this fall. This is the thing about trends. There's nothing wrong with following them, but you have to be mindful about how you can incorporate them into your existing wardrobe so you don't suddenly look like a mannequin that's just left over at the store. That's something that I'm very, very mindful of when it comes to building a wardrobe. As a person that loves to shop, it's very easy for me to go into a store and just, you know, start picking stuff up off the rack and bringing it home. I've been in situations like that, and then I look up and realize that my closet is nothing that I love. So what I want to show you today is the ways that I'm going to be incorporating the latest fall trends into what I already have going on so that nothing in my closet feels brand new or not true to me. Let's get started. First look, I wanted to show you all about what we're doing right now, which is leaning in more of to like old Americana, sort of nostalgic fashion. You can see it a lot with the dad hats with script writing, the sweatshirts with a lot of old school script. People are leaning back to this time that sort of was like old school, what people on the internet are calling old money. Sort of like the schoolgirl chic kind of look. I love it. I love structured, sort of kind of prim, proper items and, you know, selections from your closet that you can make casual. So I have on an oversized Oxford shirt. This is just from Zara that I've tied up. If I untied this shirt, it's actually like a dress, which makes it really cool because it can be worn in a variety of different ways. I keep telling y'all, I'm a hoe for a button down, okay? So I have a plethora. Then I have this cropped trench jacket, which I could not wait to have. Obviously, we all know that wearing a trench coat in the fall is ideal. It's perfect for like transitioning seasons from summer to fall, especially in places where it doesn't quickly get cold, but it's a great layering piece. I wanted something cropped because sometimes you just need a bit of like height and a little bit of depth to your outfit. Sometimes your outfit feels one note because everything is the same length and you kind of look like a blob, right? So a long item with something that's a little shorter tends to give your outfit some interest, and so that's why I really was so excited to get a cropped trench in my arsenal. Now, y'all know, okay, I'm a kid from the early 90s to 2000s, born in the 80s, baby. I love a popped collar, okay? There's nothing that's gonna make me stop popping my collar. I don't care, right? So I love to have my collars up, and then I love for you to like see the layers in the collar. This skirt that I have on is actually a skort. It's from Abercrombie, and we all know Abercrombie has had this like tremendous comeback and rebrand. Their clothes are such good quality, and actually I have a lot of their pieces and they're really, really great for basics and things like that. Now you can obviously go and get good graphic tees, but their basic items, honestly, it's tea, honey. Love it. Now, of course, I'm styling this outfit with my Longchamp. This is the Longchamp small. So you see that it has like just enough room. I put a little bits and bobbles on it for some interest, you guys know. And then I've added my Adidas Sporty and Rich Sambas to this. This is like also leaning into that sort of Americana look because of the red, white, and blue. But it has like a cream lace, which obviously I'll show you guys and get a close-up of. And so the outfit kind of gives that schoolgirl look, but it doesn't necessarily look really young, right? Sometimes when you have those kind of looks, the worry for people who are in their late 30s, early 40s, things like that, is how do I stay on trend without looking childish? So one of the key things to not doing that is really just inserting some of the trends into your wardrobe. I'm also somebody that believes that being fashionable and being stylish are two different things. being fashionable is somebody that's always going to kind of have a trend happening in their wardrobe. They see what's popping, they're going to wear it, and they're going to look cute, right? But then there's somebody who is going to be stylish, and that is a person who's probably going to have an established wardrobe, an established sort of uniform that they always come back to, but they're able to insert bits and pieces of what's trending to still remain on target and be chic without necessarily looking like a walking like advertisement for what's happening. Neither are good or bad. They're just different ways to express yourself. This look is something that clearly is on trend. We've got the skirt, the skort. We've got a traditional, always gonna be chic, classic trench coat. The way we made it a little more trendy is just by cropping it. And I'm gonna top the look off with these Prada shades that are a nod to the 90s, which this classic shape of like oval glasses is really perfect. And a lot of people can wear this. This is probably one of my favorite additions into my sunglass repertoire right now. I cannot get enough of these Prada shades. And every time I wear them out, somebody's like, oh my God, girl, your shades. Oh my God, girl, your shades. Like, these are some of my favorites. And so this, oh, I couldn't wait to style this look for you guys. But I love it. Take a good look, honey. This is how you can bring a bit of the Americana sort of nuance that's happening right now into your wardrobe and still look on point. Okay, hotties, for our second look, I went with a trouser pant and a mock neck sort of tank top. Again, as somebody that lives in a place where the seasons actually like are transitioning and it doesn't happen too rapidly, but I'm still longing for fall, I need pieces that are gonna be able to carry me from the mornings when it's really cold to the afternoons when it might warm up, and then how it quickly the temperature drops in the evening so that I can maintain like some sort of comfort throughout the day. I have these trousers with a little bit of like the sweatband or kind of like underwear kind of lining. That is something that's really trending a lot. You'll see trousers that have like the top of boxer shorts or kind of like an elastic waist look at the top of the band. I actually was kind of hesitant about getting these pants because I thought that they would be a bit low rise, but this is actually an excellent trouser. I actually love that these pants have a zipper on the side, so you're not really holding them up with the drawstring. It's a very, very well-made pair of trousers, and honestly, it's perfect for going out in the day and running errands. I even think that this could be a good travel pant because you look put together, but it's still very, very comfortable. To me, this is the perfect alternative to like wearing sweatpants. In the fall, you know, typically it gets cold, you know, you want to be comfortable and cozy, but you still want to look pulled together. And these sort of trousers are the perfect option for that. Both of these pieces are each from Zara and I got recently. Now, again, you do not have to go and try to buy everything that is trending right now. You can opt for a few pieces. Both of these things are basics and can take you through the other seasons that are happening as well. So you're not just focused on like, oh, this piece works for fall and that's it. This is like the wide leg look is something that's really in right now. I've paired this outfit with my New Balance 1906s. New Balance has done a great job of like, you know, coming into the fold, being trendy and being chic with a lot of the styles that they're revisiting. Thanks to, I would say, Joe Fresh Goods, who's had a number of excellent collaborations with them. But this pair of shoes, this 1906, so good. If you're somebody that likes the Nike Vomeros, you'll probably really enjoy these as well. They're comfortable, they're cute, they come in a variety of colorways. People are choosing comfort over like everything. But just because you're wearing comfortable shoes and you're wearing sneakers does not mean that you can't have a level of polish. And if you've been watching this channel for any amount of time, you know that polish is one of the things that I'm always hitting on. You can be casual, you can be comfortable, but you can always still have a level of polish to your outfit that makes it so that you can go anywhere at any time. Y'all know that I'm a hat girl, okay? I'm always gonna have a cute hat in place. This newest one is from Mango. And I was telling you with the last look that really sort of the old Americana style is in. You'll see on this hat, there's like a little bit of writing on it, but something that's real chill. There's always gonna be room for you to be like over accessorized, overdone up. But right now in this time of trending, we're seeing a lot of like scaled back sort of things. Everybody doesn't want their outfit to be shouting at them. And so I love like wearing a monochromatic look where everything goes together. You know what I mean? It's easy to get dressed, easy to pull on. And honestly, it's really great. So I'm gonna pair this with my Gucci Marmont flat purse. perfect little bag. This is something that usually is like my fall winter bag. I don't typically pull it out in the, you know, spring and the summer because it's just not that kind. It's quilted, it's leather, has a little chain. So I feel like it gives us something, you know, to kind of make the outfit a little funkier. Obviously, you can crossbody this or not. Now, with my sunglasses, I'm gonna put a pop of color into the outfit. Because the outfit is monochromatic, it can quickly get, like, you know, boring. And again, you may look like a blob. So to me, sunglasses and maybe a little bit of jewelry would be the perfect place to add a little bit more pizzazz to the fit. This is another one of my latest additions to my sunglass collection. This is the new Gucci. I love that these lenses have a bit of a red tint to them as well. And so if you follow me on Instagram, which obviously you know you should be, I asked the hotties over there if I should buy these, and they were like, girl, yes, add them to the collection. So I love this look with these glasses because it's still like a muted tone of red, and we all know that red is really trending right now. But Merlot, which is this color, or burgundy, wine, however you want to call it, is a classic color for fall. It will always be in. You are never not going to see it. And so you're still getting a little bit of that, oh, red is the color of this season, but wine and burgundy are definitely colors that you can always count on being in for fall. And so this is the look. Hotties, our third look. So one of the other items that is trending for this season, this fall, is the barn jacket. You may have seen it in a lot of different ways. It's sort of like an oversized just jacket that you would use to work outside. Workwear and like fashion are meeting right now. And so we're taking a lot of utilitarian items and bringing them into the fashion fold. This is not something new for fashion or style, but right now, again, with that old English, old money sort of look, this is my interpretation of that look and of that style. This is sort of an oversized look that I'm pairing together with some leggings. Again, these are some of my favorite leggings from Zara. Each season they come out with like the banded wide band pair. Just something that's very sleek, feels very comfortable, soft, but also kind of holds you in and gives you a bit of shape. I love these leggings. One of the things I like to do too is cuff on the bottom so that I can give a little bit of like breathing room to the ankle, and it gives just a little bit of distance between your shoe and the pant. I've opted to wear my Moschino loafers, which I absolutely love. My only issue with these loafers is the fact that I bought one size and it felt too small, so then I sized up and now they feel a little big, and I'm thinking, dang it, I should have kept the smaller size. You put this outfit together, and you see I still have the tags on the jacket. I haven't even taken it off. But I love it because it's lightweight, but also still feels warm. It's also something that can easily be layered. So if you actually are feeling a little cooler or in an environment where it is getting chillier faster, you could pair this barn jacket with a sweatshirt or a knit, some kind of sweater, and then you would even feel still warm. When you're a short hair shorty like me, you know, I like to have a number of little beanies to put on with my outfit. And then I usually try to wear like some sort of hoop, you know what I mean, to bring some femininity to the outfit. Especially if you are wearing like leggings and an oversized jacket, you want to feminize your outfit with little touches. I love oversized clothes, right? And as somebody who was a super tomboy growing up and did not love dresses and skirts and all of the things, I still love to add those masculine touches to my outfits. But, you know, you gotta girl them up some kind of way. I'm gonna show you the shirt, which I also got from Zara. It's a cute tank top, and it's a little backless sort of number. I love it. It's just like a little bit of a peak. And I think that it's something that's perfect for, again, if you're in transitional fall weather, because you may still be a little warm in the day, but you know, you wanna cozy up when the evening hits. This is something that I would also pair with like my corduroy hat. If I was wearing jeans just to restyle this jacket, I would wear like a pair of jeans, corduroy, because it's giving that sort of fabric for like working out. This corduroy hat I love because it says, choose the blackest option. Honestly, why would you ever choose anything else? Always bet on black. I'm gonna pair this look with my Celine Triumph bag. Something that's very simple and small, but also, again, still structured. And because it's like little and leather and is this little satchel, it almost looks like a little work bag as well, right? Something that would have tools for being outside or looking at bugs or something. I don't know, child. I'll be in the house. This is the bag that I would pair with this. It's easily going over the shoulder, you know, a little crossbody, still leaving me hands free to do my work or shop or eat or be cute. It's bringing in like the green and the gold are this pair of Blue Weve shades that I recently got over the summer. I love these because they're big enough, right? And sometimes you just don't need to put on a face. If you're wearing an outfit like this where it's like leggings, you know what I mean, a little loafer and a tank top and a big jacket, glasses are perfect for that. This is something obviously that you should just have in your repertoire of shades. You know, have a big pair that you could put on. Remember, they're the cherry on top of an outfit, and sometimes you don't want to give all of that. But if you have on a pair of glasses with your outfit, you're going to look cute. This is my interpretation of workwear for the fall and a trend that you can definitely use for after this has gone out, and it can become a classic piece in your wardrobe. I love it. All right, hotties. This next look is a little bit out of my wheelhouse because I'm not typically somebody that wears a lot of prints and patterns. But what I loved about this dress was that although it is a bit busy with the pattern, because the colors are still kind of muted, it's something that I could easily incorporate into my wardrobe. We talked a bit earlier about red being a color of this season, and so I love that I can take some red pieces and pull that color out for this outfit. This dress is from a new to me brand, which is Never Fully Dressed. It's based in the UK, and I've seen it come across my Instagram so many times, but it wasn't until this summer when I decided to pull the trigger on this dress, and I absolutely love it. I'm so glad that I did. So the dress is great because it's mesh, but it's excellent, excellent quality, and also comes with a liner underneath, which is amazing. Sometimes, you know, you get these pieces that are mesh and then there's no lining, or the lining can't be taken out, but I love that Never Fully Dressed kept in mind that you also may want to wear this just as a shirt. I've seen it styled on their website tucked in. I've seen it just worn like without anything. I myself have worn it with just like small boy shorts and a bra, and it was so great. I paired that with my LA hat, which I got from the LACMA Museum, one of my favorite places here in LA. And as you all know, LA are my initials, but it's also the city where I'm from, period. Ballet flats are a huge thing that are in this season. And you guys know I've said time and time again that I am very much in love with the ballet flat trend because it is like the dainty cousin to the loafer, which is amazing because who is really wearing heels everywhere they go? Nobody's doing that anymore. So I love the ballet slipper because it adds just a little bit of daintiness to each of your outfits. And it could take an outfit that's like jeans and leather and all that. If you put on a ballet flat, it's like, oh, now you're cute. What a little lady. Loved that. I wore those flats, which are my patent leather flats from Zara. The patent leather gives it like a little bit of a punch. You know, you can wear a big color, but remember, fabric and texture is always a way to enhance an outfit. Even though this dress is printed and kind of has a lot going on, tying in these two red pieces together on the top and the bottom makes it so that it comes together cohesively, and I really, really like it. I've got my Louis Vuitton vanity trunk, which I really love. This bag is deceptively small. You can fit so many things in here. It comes with a chain so you can wear a crossbody if you want. I love to just wear it kind of on my wrist or even in my hand. It's easy to carry. Again, because we have a lot going on, I want to keep the bag kind of quiet. Right? You never want your accessories to be competing with one another because that's how you start to look over-accessorized and over-styled. And I'm a person that believes more is more, so I'm not even saying like that you can't pile on bracelets and all the things, but everything has to have a balance and play a part to your outfit. Otherwise, one little bracelet will send you to hell, and then you are looking like you need a ticket from the fashion police. Okay? Again, on the basis of keeping it chill, I'm just gonna wear a solid pair of black glasses. That's it. Sometimes all you need is a good black pair of glasses so the people are looking at you like, who is that? Who is that? Honey, Google me, okay? Know me. And that is what these glasses do. This is a pair of Balenciaga glasses that I've had for a long time. I love these shades. They have like a good cat eye shape. Something that is never gonna go out of style. This is a classic, which you should always have in your wardrobe. So we're pairing in the fall trend of red, right? But we're keeping it cool and classic with cat eye glasses, a trunk bag, and honestly, Never Fully Dressed, y'all did that. I actually feel fully dressed and complete in this look. Hotties, we reached our final look. And as you can see, we've accessorized with a headscarf and my favorite, a baseball cap. This is from the Anine Bing line. Obviously, it's burgundy wine. I got this 2 years ago, 3 years ago. And as you can see, because we're always going to come back to that burgundy wine, like sort of deep plum colors, it's something that I can pull out in my wardrobe all the time. I have this Yves Saint Laurent scarf that you guys know I got over the summer this year, which can be paired with everything. You've seen me wear the scarf on my head. I've worn it around my neck, and now it's back on my head on top of this hat. We all know that we've seen our Muslim sisters rock things around their head, whether it's a hijab or a head wrap. We've seen people like Hailey Bieber, ASAP Rocky, me. Most people have seen the scarf around the baseball cap look. It's a trend that I can really get into. One, because I have short hair, so sometimes when it's cold outside, my head gets cold. Two, we all know I love a baseball cap. But three, this just adds a little bit of chic to the outfit. It's something that is very cute and, again, ties back into that old money sort of idea and style with a scarf wrapped around you. It looks very demure, honey. It looks mindful, okay? This sweater sort of t-shirt that I got from Zara years ago as well, in that plum wine burgundy color, and something that I pull out again and again when the season changes. And then this is a new pair of pants to me. I, for the longest time, could not wear denim. Whatever was like being treated on the cotton and on the denim used to irritate me and my legs so terribly that I literally could not wear jeans, which is why I really got into wearing trousers. I love a trouser pant. It's something that can be dressed up, dressed down. You can have it tailored, you can have it hem hauled, and everything in between to make you feel great. And so when I couldn't really wear denim, it was something that I leaned towards. If there's one material that is always going to be tied to the American experience, Americana, nostalgia, it's gonna be denim. And so by wearing them in this sort of trouser style, I've been able to get that classic polished look that I'm usually looking for in something that's really comfortable. This lightweight fabric is made to be worn during the transition season. Like, obviously I can wear this outside right now and I won't be too hot. And then when it starts to get cooler, I'll still be warm and comfortable and not out here shivering. So I'm really like loving the base of this outfit, but of course, you know, we need a few accessories. I'm gonna bring in my classic Louis Speedy, which I love. These bits and bobbles are just like a fur foot that I got from Rebecca Minkoff years and years ago. And then this pearl and chain situation that I picked up from Amazon. A Speedy is something that I feel like is such the perfect entry bag when you're trying to get into like designer styles, because it is a bag that will never, ever, ever be thrown out to the side, okay? Even if people are like, oh, I don't wear my Speedy anymore. Girl, pull it out. What are you proving to us that you don't wear your Speedy? Nothing, okay? Pull out your bag. And if you're the person who is like, I don't wear my Speedy like that, or that bag never went out of style, thank you, okay? You're right. This bag never goes out of style because obviously it's a classic monogram print from Louis Vuitton, but really it's the shape of the bag. A doctor's bag, which is the style of this, is always going to be in fashion because it's something that fits everything. It's a cute top handle. It goes with most outfits. My trusty Elisa Johnsons. Y'all, let me tell you something about Elisa. You want to know what she did? That. When it comes to these glasses, baby, she did it. I have three pair. I have brown, I have black, I have blue, and I tried to get the green and I missed out. But trust and believe, when they come back, Lily will have them, okay? I think with this look, because you already have like a scarf on your head, you have on a hat, because you're looking a little incognito, you little incognito, you need a glasses that we can see your eyes. Otherwise, you're looking shifty, okay? And I don't want to look like a shifty character. I just want to look like, you know, that girl. So I pulled on these glasses, and honestly, it's always a pair that I come back to. The browns is being picked up from the bag to the glasses. And you see that I have on my tabby flats. We all know that a good old tabby will get you through. Some people have a weird thing about tabbies because of the like horse-shaped foot, or horse-shaped toe rather. I love it. I think they're super cute. And I love these shoes. They're a satin, you know, like just little slip-on. Something cute, something to go with your little pants. And we all know that sometimes with jeans, the shape really comes and goes. So right now it's really about the barrel jean, the wide leg. But honestly, you can wear whatever jean is gonna look good on your shape. I think with denim, because it's a fabric that is never gonna go away, you have to find the best shape denim for you, and you're always gonna be on point. I enjoy a good wide leg, makes me feel great. And this outfit, I think I love it, y'all. Okay, hotties, we reached the end of today's video. If you're somebody that has been looking for tips and tricks on how to incorporate this season's trends into your existing wardrobe, I hope you were able to find something here. Dress in the way that's going to make you feel the most comfortable. But remember, choose a color palette that you can work with all year round. That way, as the seasons change and new trends come up, you're able to easily incorporate new things into what you have going on. Number two, don't feel committed to have to wear every single trend. Pick one and stick with it. We all know that like leopard is also in, red may be the color, getting a big bag is kind of back in style. If that's not for you, pick the thing that works and focus on bringing that into the wardrobe that you already have. Don't feel like you have to go buy a whole bunch of brand new items to be in vogue. Remember the differences between being fashionable and being stylish. Both of them are great. Some of us are able to go out, honey, buy the mannequin and wear it and look amazing. Others are able to keep it classic and just incorporate the trends as we go along. As always, if you loved everything that you saw in this video, be sure to subscribe, give me a big thumbs up, and share this video with everyone, and drop your comments below about your favorite part and which trend you may incorporate this season. As usual, I'm so appreciative of you being here, and I can't wait until I see you next time. Bye!